Well, okay, that's a big question. Biome is an ecological term. So biome is just all the flora and fauna that live in a particular environment. So you could think of a forest as a biome, all the animals and plants living in that forest, or the ocean is a biome. And then micro, obviously, is tiny. Microbiomes are just tiny environments, the organisms that live in those environments. And the human microbiome is just all the assemblage of all the microorganisms that live in and on our bodies. Everything from bacteria to fungi and viruses. So lots of tiny little organisms living in our guts, on our skin, in our armpits, and so on. Where do these organisms live? Well, the human body is a very diverse ecosystem. So there are many sublocations within our bodies. Our gut is the most jam-packed, full of microbes. So most of the microbes in our bodies live in our gastrointestinal system. And it's a very specific environment, right? It's dark, it's anaerobic, which means there's no oxygen around. It's moist, it's warm. And that's very different from, say, the barren wasteland of our skin, very dry, exposed to the sun. And the types of organisms that can live in these different environments vary drastically. So if you looked at the sort of ecological similarity between a gut community and a skin community, you can kind of quantify this distance in species shared between the systems. You get numbers that are similar to, you know, how similar is a desert from a rainforest, right? Really, really, really different ecosystems, and they're only separated by a few feet or a few inches on our bodies. And this microbial ecosystem in and on our bodies, we really can't avoid having it around. Large body creatures like ourselves, animals, plants, during the course of our evolution, which is a very small snapshot of the total time life has been on Earth, we've had to evolve in this milieu of microorganisms. We're just surrounded by bacteria and other microbes, and we either had to learn how to beat them or how to join them. We're either with these walking happy meals that they eat, or we somehow find a way to coexist and live together. And the human microbiome is for the most part a story of sort of neutral or positive relationship between us and our microbiota. We've learned to live with them. We're actually a pretty stable, nice environment to live on for a century or so, if we're lucky. And so there's a bit of a detente where we don't kill each other. We actually kind of provide conditions conducive to the success of both groups of organisms. So we can think of our bodies as not being completely human, but actually being an assemblage, a chimera of different species interacting to produce an overall being or organism. And so a lot of the health and well-being of our body system is outsourced and pent up in our microorganisms that have been with us for so long and been co-evolving with us. So we provide a home for them, we provide food to them, and for us, they provide protection from pathogens, they help us digest our food, they help educate our immune systems, and so much.